Assalamu alaikum. This presentation is for BBA 8 and the subject is International Business and Trade, which is presented by Ms. Zara. Today, we will discuss free trade and protectionism. First of all, we need to know that what is free trade. Free trade is said to take place between countries when there are no barriers to trade put in place. When there are no barriers, means the goods are freely to move from one place to another without any barrier. Now, what is protectionism? Any measure designed to give local producer of goods or services an advantage over the foreign competitors. Mean, when the local producer are given any advantage, then that would be known as protectionism. Now, arguments for protectionism. There are many arguments for protecting local producers and industries. These include protecting domestic employment, protecting the economy from low-cost labor, protecting an infant or sunrise industry to avoid the risk of over-specialization, strategic reasons, and to prevent dumping. First of all, we will discuss the protecting domestic employment. Argument for protectionism, that why there should be protection. First of all, it says that the industries which are declining, mean the sunset industries that cannot compete in the foreign countries, we need to protect them. If the industries are relatively larger, this will lead to high level of structural unemployment. But if the industries are small, that will lead to the close down of that particular industry. It means that the person who are working in that particular industry will lose their job. So this is the argument for protectionism, that there should be protection so that those employees can be saved. Now, the counter argument for free trade, it says that this industry will continue to decline and protecting will simply prolong that process. It says that the industry will decline, but if it is not now, it will in future. Although there will be a short-term social cost, it could be better to let the resources employed in another country. It says that there should be a free trade, that if the industry is going to be shut down, it should be shut down and we can use these resources in any other way. Then, argument for protecting the economy from low-cost labor. It is often argued that the main reason for declining domestic industry is the low-cost labor in the exporting countries. The economy should be protected for import that is produced in countries where the low-cost labor is very low. For example, U.S. clothing industry. They are saying that the U.S. should protect its low-cost labor. What are they doing? They are importing the cheap goods from the Asia, so due to which the low wages, the labor is affecting. So they should protect them. Protecting the economy from low-cost labor, counter argument for free trade. It says that if you protect the economy from the low-cost labor, it means that the consumer will pay higher prices. Means that if we are not getting cheap product from the abroad, from the foreign country, it means that we are producing things at a higher cost. Higher cost means that the people are going to buy these things at a higher cost. So they are going to pay more prices. So this will be a disadvantage for the consumer, not for the producer. Then, argument for protectionism, protecting an infant industry. It says that an infant industry, a sunrise industry, do not have any resources, do not have sufficient finance to establish, to produce goods at a lesser prices. So what should government do? Government should protect them so that the people, government should not import the goods which these sunrise industries are producing, so that the people are forced to buy that particular product. When the people will buy that particular product, so this would be a protection for them. What is the counter argument for this? Most developed countries have highly efficient capital market which allow them access to the large amount of capital, financial capital, even more so since the advent of globalization. Due to this fact, it can be argued that there is no basis for the idea that industries in developed countries will set up a relatively small way. They could be able to benefit from economies of scale with relatively shorter period of time. So they said that because there is a globalization, so they can easily access for the larger amount of financial capital. So they cannot say that they have no financial resources, so there should be a free trade to avoid the risk of over-specialization. Now, what would they say, argument for the protection? Government may want to limit over-specialization. It means the country could become over-dependent on export sales of one or two products. Any change in the world market for these products might have serious consequences for the country's economy. For example, changes in technology can severely reduce the demand for commodity as the development of the quartz crystal watches state for the Swiss watches industry harming the economy. What it says that to avoid the risk of over-specialization, agar aap kisi ke upar bhi over-specialize karte ho, to uske andar risk hai. Usme kya hai? Risk hai. To aapko kya chahiye hai ki aapko apne country ki jo infant industries hain, over-specialization ho ke karna hai, protection deni hai. Kya karna hai? Protection deni hai. Should not depend on one or two. Protection doge. If you are producing, let's suppose that Pakistan is an agrarian country, so Pakistan produces more and more of agriculture. It is depending on the agriculture. So this is bad. So we should protect our all industries, said all industries should produce more and more. To avoid the risk of over-specialization, the introduction of new products and changes in the pattern of demand and supply can have serious effect on the economies of developing countries. For example, oversupply of coffee on the world market caused the fall in prices and has severe effect on countries like Ethiopia. Now, counter argument for free trade, there is no real argument against this. So, we can only say that it does not promote protectionism. It simply point out the problem of countries may face if they specialize. कोई हम ये नहीं कह सकते कि counter argument इसका free trade के लिए क्या है. हम सिर्फ ये कह सकते हैं कि what are the problems. अगर वो specialization करते हैं तो उनको problems कौन-कौन से face करने पड़ते हैं. Arguments for protection, strategic reason. It is sometimes argued that certain industries need to be protected. In this case, they are needed at times of war. For example, agriculture trade means sometimes there is a strategy that we need to protect. But against, on the other hand, counter argument is that there is no war. There is no war. This is often overstated that there would be a war, so we need to protect this certain industry. So free trade says that there is no war. Argument for protection to prevent dumping. First of all, we need to know that what is dumping. Dumping is the selling by a country of large quantity of the commodity at price lower than its production cost. Dumping mein kya hota hai ki aap apni quantities ko apni production cost se bhi kam pe dusre country ko sell kar dete ho. Isse kya hota hai ki let's suppose that America is selling its product here in Pakistan lesser than cost. What will do? It will harmfully affect the industries which are producing that particular product. For example, the European Union have a surplus of butter and sell this at a very low cost to the small developing countries. Where countries can prove that the industries have been severely damaged by dumping, their governments are allowed under international trade rules to impose anti-dumping measures to reduce damage. However, it is difficult to prove whether or not foreign industries are guilty of dumping. What will happen? That if certain countries is dumping in your country, then your country will severely affect by that. So there should be a protectionism. Counter argument, a government that subsidizes a domestic industry may actually support dumping. For example, developing countries argue that when European Union exports subsidized sugar, it is actually a game of dumping because the price does not reflect the actual cost. Therefore, if dumping does occur, it is more likely that there will be a need of talk between government rather than any protection. What will they say? That there should not be protection. If they are giving something at lower cost, then there should be a talk between the governments. They should solve that particular problem, not the people. Now, argument for protection to protect product standard. A country might wish to to impose safety, healthy and environmental standard on goods being imported into a domestic market in order to ensure that the import matches the standard of the producer. What will happen, for example, European Union has banned the importing of American beef. They said that these are treated with the hormones. What will happen with this? They will retaliate. If they are going to ban their product, they will ban their product. So counter argument for free trade is many of the reasons given for the bans and standards are not reached are considered to be simply stubble means of protection. When there is a dispute over product standard, a response of the exporting country might be used retaliatory policy. So what will they do? They will retaliate. Then to raise government revenue. In many developing countries, it is difficult to collect taxes, and so government importers import tariff on product in order to raise revenue. IMF estimated that on average, import duties accounted for approximately 15% of total government revenue for developing countries in 2002. Counter argument is there is not so much an argument for protectionism, but more a means of raising revenue. It says, koi हमारे पास कोई प्रोटेक्शनिज्म के अगेंस्ट नहीं है, बट क्या होता है, इससे आपका रेवेन्यू रेज होता है. इन इफेक्ट अगर प्रोटेक्शनिज्म है तो क्या हो रहा है, आपको रेवेन्यू जनरेट हो रहा है. फ्री ट्रेड में तो रेवेन्यू नहीं जनरेट होता. इन इफेक्ट द इम्पोर्ट ड्यूटीज आर एक्चुअली अ टैक्स ऑन कंज्यूमर इन कंट्री हु आर बाइंग द इम्पोर्ट. देन टू करेक्ट द बैलेंस ऑफ पेमेंट, गवर्नमेंट समटाइम्स इम्पोजेस प्रोटेक्शनिस्ट मेजर टू अटेम्प्ट टू रिड्यूस इम्पोर्ट एक्सपेंडिचर एंड दस इम्प्रूव करंट अकाउंट डेफिसिट. समथिंग गवर्नमेंट क्या करती है प्रोटेक्शनिज्म क्यों करती है, कि वो कहती है कि इम्पोर्ट्स कम हो जाए और एक्सपोर्ट ज़्यादा हो जाए. व्हेन द इम्पोर्ट्स विल रिड्यूस एंड द एक्सपोर्ट विल इंक्रीज देन द बैलेंस ऑफ पेमेंट डेफिसिट विल रिड्यूस. बट काउंटर आर्गूमेंट इज दैट इट विल वर्क ओनली इन शॉर्ट रन, इट डज नॉट एक्चुअली एड्रेस द एक्चुअल प्रॉब्लम एंड द डेफिसिट विल परसिस्ट अगेन. नाउ all the counter arguments previously covered are greater arguments for free trade. Now there are more arguments for the protectionism which we will discuss further. Number one is the prices. Protection may rises the prices to the consumer and producer of imports they buy. What will happen due to protection? The prices will high. Choice. As there is a protectionism, then there will be less choice for the consumer to buy the product. Competition would diminish. If there is protectionism, then it means that there is no international trade, international competitors are not coming here in the market, their products are not coming. When their products are not coming, then there would be no competition. And when there would be no competition, then they will not minimize the cost, they will not improve their quality as well. Comparative advantage. Protectionism distorts comparative advantage, leading to inefficient use of world resources. So they will not work on the comparative advantage issue. What will they do? They will not do the comparative advantage issue, due to which they will inefficiently use their resources. Economic growth. For all reasons listed previously, protection may hinder the economic growth, because due to the protection, foreign trade will not flourish. When foreign trade will not flourish, then it might happen that it may hinder the economic growth. Thank you.